Hi everyone. So today I am finally going to do a spring DIY. It's been a hot minute since I've done DIYs on my channel. It's just kind of because I was doing so many there towards the end of 2015 that I kind of needed a break, so I've been doing a lot of planning videos. I know that's not for everybody here on my channel, and I do such a huge variety of things, and I'm so grateful that you guys subscribe to me and stick with me through all of it, even if some of the videos really isn't like your kind of style of videos. So I'm super appreciative of that. I checked my subscriber count this morning and I was like 25,000. Are you kidding me? I was at 10,000 just last year. It blows my mind where I'm at today, and I just am so grateful for all of you. Thank you so much. First Wednesday of the month. I'm only filming a DIY. I am going to have many DIYs coming in the future, more spring DIYs. I'm actually going to do a couple of Easter DIYs for you guys as well. And I'm actually going to also be doing just some regular, everyday kind of home decor DIY. I know I had a subscriber request that. I have not forgotten, and I'm going to be doing that in the future. There are a couple of little things that I really do need to update in my house. And so all of these DIYs that I share with you, just so that you know, they're actual things that I use, that I make for myself. And I just like to share it with you guys and share how I think things can be really pretty on a budget. So today, I am going to be showing you. Would you believe me if I told you this whole entire thing was Dollar Tree? Everything. The jar, the twine, the floral. Yes. I know if you watch my videos, you know that I get really dramatic about my DIYs, but it never fails. It's without fail. It will continue to happen. Every time I do a DIY from Dollar Tree, I just flip out. These are so gorgeous. I think these, again, are great for decorating, for gifts, for your neighbors, friends, family, teachers. So beautiful. The one question I get asked all the time is, what am I going to put in these? Most of the time, when I make my jar DIYs for myself, they're actually just decor items and I leave them empty like this. I just kind of like them beautiful like this and empty. And usually they go in my kitchen. So I am going to attach some photos at the end of different places that I have put these throughout my house so that you can kind of see just a couple of different variations. But let your creativity flow. And I'm telling you also that the Dollar Tree had red sunflowers and blue sunflowers. So very pretty. Lots of things you can do. If you have four friends, make a different flower for each friend. Put a couple little spring goodies in here. Or if your child has four teachers, you know, each teacher can get a different color. I don't know if this is a sunflower. Like, what would you call this? Without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the tutorial. Everything that I used here was from the Dollar Tree. So I got two of the jars with the white lids from the Dollar Tree and two sets of the floral clips from the Dollar Tree as well, and the color twine from the Dollar Tree as well, plus scissors and a glue gun. So the first thing that I started off by doing was peeling off the sticker. And if you peel anything from the Dollar Tree, sometimes it just ruins the whole thing and you have to work really hard to peel it. But I noticed that if you peel very slowly, it is more successful, and if that doesn't work for you, then some hot water and soap really works well. So be sure to wash your jars if you are using them as gifts. So here I am going to take the green jute cord that I purchased from the Dollar Tree, and I am going to begin by hot gluing the twine to the lid. So I'm starting off with a little piece of hot glue and then adding my twine so that I have a base for it to grab so that it won't move around or slip around. And then I'm just going to wrap the twine all around the lid. Now, if you are going to give these as gifts, then go ahead and add hot glue all the way as you go, just to make it more durable and stable so that the twine doesn't kind of slip around. But I really didn't feel the need to do that. I just kind of hot glued here and there as I was wrapping it around the lid, just because I use it as a decor and really don't mess with it that often. So just sitting here, wrapping it all the way around. I take a couple of breaks to add some hot glue, and I will say that it's very important to add hot glue all the way around the lid to your very last strip to the top of the lid, especially if you work from bottom to the top, because you don't want that top piece of twine to kind of like slide off or anything like that. Now that I am done, I'm going to move on to the final step. That's how easy this whole entire DIY is that I'm just going to take this floral clip and I'm going to pair a yellow flower with the green jute cord. And what I loved about these from the Dollar Tree is that the little alligator clip just came off super easily. I didn't have to break part of the floral to get rid of it. It just kind of peeled right off. But that little stem that you see there, we've got to clip it off so that we are working with more of a flat surface. So then I just take my hot glue gun, apply a ton of hot glue to the back of it, and it looks like it's like popped up and raised, but once I folded it onto the lid, it actually popped down. I don't know if that makes any sense, but that little green part underneath just flopped down and it was a complete flat surface. And that is it, you guys. So now I'm moving on, doing my second jar. This was so fun to make, so fast, so simple. And it was so inexpensive. Each jar was $1, each twine, jute cord, whatever, was $1, and you get 2 florals per package for $1. So if you do these as gifts, it's very inexpensive and it's super cute. So as you can see, I'm basically just repeating the same process, and I really hope that you guys love this DIY, and I hope that it allows your creativity to flow. And I just wanna say that don't let crafts and DIYs intimidate you. I always do things by trial and error. You never know what something's going to look like, so don't feel like you have to be advanced to do any kind of DIY. Just try it. If you love it, just try it. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'm gonna attach some photos and have a really good day.